How tall should you be? It seems an odd question, but the answer may illustrate how fundamentally unsustainable human industrial civilization is. In the modern developed world, we are on average taller than we ever have been, and average height seems to be increasing with each subsequent generation. If this continues, how big will human beings get? How big can they get? At what point do people become too big? Perhaps we're already too big. Physical constraints limit body size to a degree, and tall people tend to die younger than their shorter counterparts of an equal socio-economic status. However, tall people are more likely to be of a high socio-economic status, so from a Darwinian perspective, this offsets their innate health problems. Rich people live longer, regardless of height. So why are human beings getting taller? The obvious answer is improved nutrition. We eat more and are getting bigger as a result. This is true in part, but there's more to it than that. The perceived wisdom is that we started out as hunter-gatherers, eking out an existence from the natural world until we discovered farming. Then we produced more food and got taller. As improvements in farming came along, nutrition improved and our height increased. With new technologies, this increase of nutrition and height continued further. However, this may be true for a tiny minority of elites, but for the vast majority, this is not what really happened. In the late 1800s, the tallest known people in the world were the Plains Indians of North America, hunter-gatherers. And it seems to be the case that most hunter-gatherers in productive natural environments were relatively tall. In fact, the introduction of agriculture in Europe resulted in poorer nutrition and shorter people. With the introduction of mechanized industry, they got shorter still, and it was not until the mid-20th century that Europeans outgrew their hunter-gatherer forebears. That is, once oil energy came to the fore and increased productivity massively. Since then, one can also add to this our seeming cultural preference for tall people. Tall people are more likely to pass job interviews, get pay rises, and most importantly, tall men have more sexual partners. When and why women started sexually selecting taller men is another question entirely, as such preferences seem to be an alien concept to hunter-gatherer tribes that still exist today. Sexual dimorphism regarding height is actually not that common in hunter-gatherers. It seems likely that this kind of sexual selection evolved in larger, less personal, and potentially more violent societies. So that's how we ended up being taller on average than we ever have been. But are we too tall? On average, not yet, but there are plenty of people for whom the answer to that question is yes. Some people are simply too physically large to sustain themselves and survive unless they live in a modern civilization that is awash with excess energy from oil. But how tall is too tall? How tall should you be? Well, the answer seems to be somewhere around the 6 foot mark. That seems to be the maximum height for hunter-gatherers, past or present. Some individuals may have been taller, but they were probably reliant on excess produced by others. The bigger you are, the more energy it takes to sustain you, and the more energy you must expend in order to survive. At some point, there is an equilibrium between energy consumption and expenditure that is most efficient, and that point seems to be well below 6 feet in our natural state. That's not to say in the event of some kind of apocalypse, tall people won't survive. Still having clothes, tools and weapons would probably save enough energy to enable relatively easy survival. However, it's a certainty that oil will run out, and unless a renewable or inexhaustible alternative energy source can replace it, then modern humans must get smaller or perish. We are so immersed in our industrial civilization that our very bodies reflect how unsustainable it is. We've bred many domestic animals that couldn't survive naturally, and it seems we may be unwittingly doing the same to ourselves. Have we become irreversibly domesticated?